with the motion, obviously, but before I really go on with the motion and my important substantives for the debate, I would like to talk for a second about what I was really imagining that this side proposition would come and say, and what I couldn't even fathom, but still they came and said it nonetheless. Their burden was to really defend the right, the privacy right of public individuals and public figures, and to an extent I had expected that. But what I really couldn't fathom, ladies and gentlemen, and may I say this most honorably, that they, in their progressive crusade, in their very, very progressive crusade to fight for the rights of privacy and privacy for the public individuals, would ultimately come and impose censorship upon the greater mass at large. Ladies and gentlemen, let me address this through the motion that we are debating today. The motion reads, the private life of a public figure is of no concern to the public. And may I implore upon you to ask this question, what is this no mean? What does this no mean, ladies and gentlemen? Are we supposedly going to take a stand that whatever a public individual will do will be beyond scrutiny? To that extent, they have conceded. But then again, they have not really identified to the extent of the scrutiny that will be allowed to us. It is really, to an extent, most surprising that side proposition is rather acting like the government of most nations, where the government chooses to really impose upon the choices of the public, including my choice to be an informed citizen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let us for a second understand whether this debate is really about privacy or not. Even though side proposition would have us to believe that this is about privacy, but when I read this, this is really not about privacy. This is really about the citizenry's right to be an informed citizenry and the citizenry's crusade to build a more vibrant democracy, a more vibrant market, a more vibrant economy. Why do I say this? Let us take the examples of our lives, ladies and gentlemen. In this world of crony political discourses, very, very radical left politics, very, very crony capitalist politics, one very important and one of those unavoidable circumstances that we are left with is crony consumerism emanating from crony capitalism. Now, what has this crony consumerism done to your lives, ladies and gentlemen? You wake up in the morning and you go to your bathroom to brush your teeth. Shah Rukh Khan has had you for the toothpaste that you would use, and Salman Khan has had you for the toothbrush. When you come back home, Ranbir Kapoor and Ranveer Singh, apart from fighting over many other things, have also had you for the kind of bath slippers that you are supposed to choose for yourself. Now, ladies and gentlemen, when these public figures are going to commercially exploit your private choices to meet their own private ends, are we not supposed to know whether they really mean their endorsements and live their endorsements or not? Whether these public figures really say something on the television screen to just commercially exploit our choices and then go back to their own choices? I would like, obviously there should be some semblance over there. I wouldn't want my younger brother to take his driving lessons from Salman Khan, but I would certainly want my younger brothers and my friends over here to at least go ahead and figure out some of the important struggles that many of these public individuals have had to encounter before they really became the public individuals that they are known for. Why not figure out and why not learn from the struggle of J.K. Rowling, who's now a world-class piece of Harry Potter, but that Harry Potter series was actually rejected by 100 publishers before it was finally accepted by one. And the grit and the perseverance of that public figure has to be known, because there is a lot to learn. I completely deny and disagree with side proposition here, who over here today has come and have tried to paint this picture, and I do not know why, that most of the things that our public individuals do are really something that we shouldn't be concerned about. In fact, in their criticism for Arnab Goswami, I must point this out, had Arnab Goswami been here today, he would have agreed to side proposition in spite of their criticism. Arnab Goswami believes that the nation wants to know each and everything about our public individuals because of our
Saptarshi
public individuals have a lot to hide. So ladies and gentlemen, let me leave here, but before I leave, let me leave you with one simple question. To implore upon what is being said by side proposition and what is being said by side opposition. Side proposition wants to show and put up this facade of fight for the right of privacy, but in essence what they are doing is really imposing censorship. We on the other hand are really advocating the cause of a more informed citizen.
Thank you. According to Saptarshi, when public figures can influence their private choice, why can't the private person has the right to know the privacy of the public life? That's the proposition you wanted to put forward. Now I call upon